John Newsinger, who's an author, most recently of 1917, Russia's Good Year, along with Tim Sanders, also editor of John Reed, Shaking the World, Revolutionary Journalism.
When you look at the events of 1917, I mean, the first thing, obviously, is the context of the war. You know, I would argue this was an imperialist war in which all the sides engaged were trying to get as much territory, control of as much of the world resources as possible, and the ruling classes in every country were prepared to sacrifice however many lives it took to achieve their ends. I think it can be reduced to that. And there's plenty of evidence that they were aware of this. I mean, Lloyd George, after the war, actually on one occasion said it had been a very good war because of what Britain had got out of it. And one of the things he specifically mentioned was Iraqi oil, you know, which I think was pretty prescient at the time.
Jill's first book was about the radical suffragists in Lancashire. Later she wrote about women campaigners in Yorkshire, and there's also rebel girls as well.
What I want to do, if I may, is to tell the story of the Votes for Women campaign across Leeds through three of the city's most celebrated suffrage campaigners: Isabella Ford, Mary Gawthorpe, Leonora Cohen. And I want them to take us through the last few peacetime years, about the outbreak of war, and on to, of course, June 1917 in the Leeds Convention, where national suffrage campaigners, including Ethel Snowden, Charlotte Despard, and Dora Montefiore, all spoke. And then we'll go on to the parliamentary debates about women's suffrage and the passing of the Representation of the People's Bill, February 1918. Votes for Women at long last.
He'd always wanted to be a writer, and of course, like many men mothers, didn't think it was a proper job. And he's now got no qualifications to speak of, so he found himself a job in London with a publisher. And he was very much the dog's body, the office dog's body. He opened the post, he made party parcels of books, he delivered books, that sort of thing. But it didn't meet writers who came in to see the publishers. And he began to move in a literary milieu. He wrote stories himself, little articles, got them published, and was eventually able to give up his day job and subsist, not well off, subsist on, in fact, his income from writing. In 1909, he married, and the following year had a daughter, Tabitha. It was not a happy marriage at all, and it was one of the reasons why he first went to Russia in 1913. But this desertion of his wife and his child was to leave a terrible legacy. Ivy was determined to make him pay, both emotionally and financially. She was vindictive, she turned his daughter against him, and she refused to give him a divorce, which was why he and Trotsky's secretary couldn't get married until after 1924, when she did finally relent and give him a divorce.